This is Delta Launch Control. We've had a successful spacecraft separation of OCO2, and the mission is on track for providing us with a healthy spacecraft, as well as having had a successful flight on the Delta 2. And here to talk about that with us is Tim Dunn, who was our NASA launch manager during the countdown. Tim, first of all, tell us what your understanding is about the satellite itself, and then tell us how the flight went.
Okay, so I just left the Mission Director Center, where I was chatting with the spacecraft mission director, and he had just received confirmation that solar arrays have deployed. They are in contact with OCO2, and the solar arrays were functional, and they were power positive. All very good news.
All right, so we've met our mission objective right off the bat, as far as getting it to the right place at the right time. So how did the countdown and the flight look to you?
Well, the countdown was extremely smooth, very quiet. You probably noticed that there was not a lot of chatter on the nets.
It was very quiet.
We had no anomalies to discuss on our anomaly net. The range, I want to thank the 30th Space Wing. They had an impeccable range for us to launch on. Not a single instrumentation issue to discuss throughout the countdown. The spacecraft was rock solid in the fairing during the entire countdown. Delta 2 performed like a champ after almost 3 years back on the pad. Although this was our second attempt at launching, it all came together tonight. And we did experience that disappointment that we didn't get off on our first attempt yesterday. But being the professional team that we are, bounced right back, did what we needed to do, came in today, and now we're celebrating. There was pure joy in the Mission Director Center at Spacecraft SEP. I can tell you that.
Well, Tim, it's good to know that we've had a good flight, and we're already seeing that OCO2 is right on. We're going to be having a post-launch briefing here very shortly at 5:30 Pacific time, and we'll have our project manager from JPL, Ralph Basilio, tell us exactly what the state of health of OCO2 is. But in any event, Tim, tell us, we've got another Delta 2 coming up out here before too long.
Yes, actually, just this November, we're going to be back out. The LSP team will be back out here at Vandenberg for the SMAP mission, the Soil Moisture Active Passive mission. So we're really looking forward to that, another mission on Delta 2. So, George, if I could, I would like to mention something that you brought up yesterday during our first attempt, and that was this mission was particularly special to Launch Services Program because we dedicated it to one of our teammates, Lori Walls, who passed away earlier in June. So Lori was a founding member of LSP, had been with the program the entire time until her death, and we dedicated this mission to her. And she would have been thrilled with this. She loved Delta 2. I worked many missions with her. And so we're really happy that we could honor her with this. There was a memorial decal that was placed on the fixed umbilical tower. So,
yeah, she certainly would be very happy with the successful outcome of this flight tonight.
Indeed. Yes.
Well, that's going to conclude our launch commentary coverage for this flight of the Delta 2 with OCO2. Stay tuned for the post-launch news conference at 5:30 Pacific time. And this will bring us to a conclusion of our coverage for tonight's launch. This is Delta Launch Control.